It is extraordinarily difficult for a human being to kill a member of their own species. They have to be manipulated into it. And when you look deeper into the battle, you'll see that the history of warfare is ever more successful mechanisms to manipulate people into killing. We studied in World War II the individual rifleman for the first time in history. And we found out that only 15 to 20% of the individual riflemen, when left to their own devices, would fire their weapon at an exposed enemy soldier. This is not a good thing. A 15% firing rate among your riflemen is like a 15% literacy rate among your librarians. So what we did was we went about the process of making killing a conditioned response. In World War II, we taught our soldiers to fire at bullseye targets. And that training was tragically flawed because no bullseyes appeared on the battlefield. And what we converted to were pop-up man-shaped silhouettes. If you want a person to be able to kill a human being, they have to practice shooting at human beings. A few hundred repetitions of that, and now on the battlefield, when an enemy soldier pops up in front of us, boom, the soldier kills, and he kills reflexively. It is an extraordinarily effective mechanism. It is basic operant conditioning. Now we use large screen TVs, and soldiers stand with plastic M16s that fire laser beams, and when you hit the target on the screen, the target drops. The law enforcement community extensively uses a device known as the FATS trainer, firearms training simulator. You hold the gun in your hand, you pull the trigger, the slide slams back, you feel the recoil, you hit the target drops, you miss the target shoots you. It is a very effective law enforcement training device. But if you go to the local video arcade, you'll find an almost identical device. A game such as Time Crisis, for example, in which you fire the pistol, the slide slams back, it recoils in your hand. If you hit the target drops. If you miss the target shoots you. The only difference is, in the FATS trainer, if you shoot the wrong target, you'll be reprimanded, ultimately even fired. But when the kids are playing the game, there is no adult supervision, there is no standard, there is no control. The Marine Corps uses the game Doom as a training device. It is such an effective and efficient tactical trainer. There's limited skill involved with this game, but there's a great deal of rehearsal and will processes involved here. A lot of people, when we talk about Doom or Quake or the first-person shooter games, they say, well, all you're doing is playing with a mouse or a keyboard. How can that be teaching you killing skills? Well, understand that Doom all by itself, even used with a keyboard, is good enough that the Marine Corps uses it to script killing in their soldiers. It provides the script, the rehearsal, the act of killing. Now, we have to understand that the military around the world and law enforcement organizations around the world do not use these killing simulators and spend billions of dollars on these simulators for fun. They do it because it works. It is their job to condition and enable people to kill. They know what they're doing. They are the professionals. They have had experiment after experiment to show the value of these simulators, but the greatest experiments are things like World War II, where only 15 to 20% of the riflemen fired, and Vietnam, where 95% of the riflemen fired. It is a revolution on the battlefield. And we know it works. And those whose job it is to enable people to kill use it extensively, and they do it for a reason, because if they didn't, their soldiers would die in combat.